In a post-Cold War era full of violence, a person's safety is constantly at risk. A normal day at work could end in a murder. A happy marathon ends in a manhunt.
Just before 2:50.
In order to prevent such tragedies and keep civilians safe, the CIA has to stay on top of the ever-changing information.
One way the CIA carries out their missions is through secret prisons or black sites.
Black sites have been highlighted in the news in past years.
Rendition revealed. From now on, you can learn exactly how the CIA has been secretly transferring its war on terror detainees across the globe on civic and military aircraft, something better known as the Rendition Program.
Despite its best efforts, the CIA has not been able to keep these secret prisons secret. An ABC News investigative team was able to track down and for the first time find one of the actual sites, 12 miles outside the capital of Lithuania in Vilnius.
But attention was never fully given to the issue until 2006, when President Bush announced that the U.S. operated secret prisons overseas.
In these cases, it has been necessary to move these individuals to an environment where they can be held secretly, questioned by experts, and when appropriate, prosecuted for terrorist acts. They are in our custody, so they cannot murder our people. A small number of suspected terrorist leaders and operatives captured during the war have been held and questioned outside the United States in a separate program operated by the Central Intelligence Agency. Many specifics of this program, including where the detainees have been held and the details of their confinement, cannot be divulged. Doing so would provide our enemies with information they could use to take retribution against our allies and harm our country.
Secret prisons exist in over 60 countries. These sites exist outside the U.S. to avoid U.S. legal jurisdiction. Therefore, the U.S. abandons all responsibility of the activities in these prisons to the host countries.
December 5th, 2002, 2:56 p.m., a Gulfstream G4 lands in a tiny airport in northeastern Poland. Seven passengers exit the plane, slide into an SUV, and drive off.
The seven men, later identified as six CIA agents and one prisoner, travel 13.7 miles north to a training center used by the Polish Secret Service called Starej Kajeti.
Until 2003, when Stare Kachetki was closed, it served as a CIA secret prison where alleged Al-Qaeda members were held, questioned, and supposedly tortured.
It is suspected that the prisoners held here were interrogated using the five techniques of stress and duress interrogation.
Because these methods are extremely controversial and in some cases illegal, the U.S. only uses these techniques in foreign prisons where U.S. law cannot be enforced.
Fresh allegations have emerged of secret CIA prisons around the world and violations that have allegedly been taking place there. A New York-based NGO funded by one of America's richest men, George Soros, has unveiled a report which claims to detail the operation of these so-called black sites.
Polish media said on Tuesday prosecutors had charged a former head of Poland's intelligence service with helping set up secret CIA detention centers at the height of the US war on terror in the early 2000s. We will try to avert negative consequences of the investigation and clarification of this case within the government's capabilities.
It is ripe with human rights abuses, and it's clear that high-ranking Bush administration officials bear responsibility for authorizing human rights violations, and yet no one was prosecuted.
Nobody can have any doubts about that, neither in Poland or on the other side of the ocean.
The investigation began when the flight records revealed that at least two prisoners had been held at the training center illegally. The investigation continued when rumors surfaced that torture had been used at the facility.
Poland's former president Aleksander Konakweski originally claimed that he was unaware of the prison at the time the list was published.
However, the former president recently revoked his original claim.
Abad al-Rahim al-Nazari and Zain al-Abidin Muhammad Hussein are the two men tearing the Polish government apart. However, they must leave the proceedings to their lawyers as they are still being held in Guantanamo indefinitely.
The options open to us is to bury our heads in the sand, in the belief that nobody can see our behinds. Oh yes, they can.
The investigation has cost Poland valuable time and money, in addition to global scrutiny. The United States has not aided Poland in the issue, despite the fact that they are the root cause. Although the charges have been withdrawn, there are many side effects of the investigation. The investigation embarrassed the top echelons of the country's government by linking them with an illegal detention and alleged torture center.
If they prove that there were such prisons in Poland, I'd say that will even be a good thing, because all that was done for the sake of Polish-American cooperation. The question, though, is how Poland will benefit from that. How could Poland benefit from that? That's the question.
The U.S. has consistently claimed that they stand for justice, fair prosecution, and taking responsibility for actions since the Revolutionary War. However, the U.S.'s reaction to the Polish investigation drastically contradicts the aforementioned ideals. The media attention which the case attracted painted the U.S. as hypocrites and caused strain on the U.S.-Polish relations.
Now that new facts of that secret cooperation have emerged, the governments of Poland, Lithuania, and Romania have found themselves in the focus of high-profile political rows. The prisons affair has cost some their political careers. Others have lost their lives.